Nick's got one of my dishes on the menu. He's been cooking for as long as I have, and he's charging top London prices. So I just hope his food measures up. First test, a fish soup.
Excellent. And, smells off.
Well, that's certainly seen better days. I just hope I won't be saying the same about Nick by the end of the lunch.
Ah, oh, you bastard. It's not worked very well. Shit. Son of a bitch.
Next, mushroom and a duck egg on toast, and it's one of my favourites. When it's done how I like it, simply.
Why is it supposed to be looking like something out of a fucking Barbie's doll's house? Why can't it just look simple, plain, and mushrooms on toast? It's like eating a wet flannel. Soggy, horrible bread. Mushrooms are dirty.
Nick's obviously a frills man, but if he's got any sense, he'll serve the next dish as it was intended, because it's one of mine.
And where did this dish originate from?
I couldn't tell you where he sort the idea out.
You couldn't?
No.
No. Go and ask him for me, will you?
Yeah, sure.
Thank you.
Where did you get the idea for the scallops?
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Thank fuck I don't serve mine like that. They taste frozen, unfortunately. Milky and, yeah, rubbery.
So they tasted like they were frozen, they were milky.
Scallops?
Try one, yeah.
They're not frozen. Fresh scallops.
Nick's got to be joking. He'd better put a smile on my face with the next dish, because so far, this lunch has been miserable.
It's nearly there. Just wondering if there's any point in sending it, to be honest.
If I were you, Nick, I wouldn't keep me waiting.
There we go, Lawrence. Thank you.
All right.
Cool. You're like a hemorrhoid in my arsehole, you know that? Can I just sit and enjoy, or try to enjoy, rather than trying to dissect everything I eat? Otherwise, you may as well fucking sit down here and take my place. Would you mind?
No, no problem at all.
Thank you so much.
Enjoy me out. I'm nervous. I say stupid things that I don't mean.
At least you're not having a cut for it.
That sauce is so sweet, it's unbelievable. The duck itself actually tastes quite nice, but then it's marred with all that horrible sauce. It's almost like Benelin and baby veg.
20 quid as well. I mean, you know, even by London prices, that's, you know, that's up there.
There's someone here that's trying to be flash, and he may have got away with that in the 90s, but in 2006, his days are numbered.
Right. Nick, you're not going to like what I'm about to say. I expected a nice, quick, fast, easy lunch, and unfortunately everything was painful. You know, mushrooms on toast was supposed to be mushrooms on toast. I got something that was incredibly soggy, full of grit, and just looked horrendous. The duck was fucking delicious, and then everything else around it was so unnecessary.
Right.
You were fucking successful 10 years ago, and you had a big following.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, nothing has moved on.
No.
You're in the bubble, and I'm about to burst it. Sat on these laurels, clearly cooking still from the 90s era. Touched success, but that fizzled very, very quickly. Even his own customers haven't sort of hung around long enough to tell him how fucking long-winded the food's become. So it's, yeah, it's quite sad in a way. And he's clearly not cooking for King's Lynn, he's cooking for his ego.
I feel slightly deflated. I didn't think I'd get as much criticism as I got, but hey, I'm a big boy. I'm not a 20-year-old, I'm not gonna cry, I'm 40, so.
Yeah.
Bring it on.